Good morning to all. In this today's video, we are going to see about the Wheatstone Bridge. So this is the application part of the Kirchhoff's rule. So Kirchhoff's rule, yesterday we learned about that. So first rule and second rule. First rule, current rule. Second rule, voltage rule. So here we have to apply that Kirchhoff's rule here. So in this Wheatstone Bridge, it is used to determine the unknown resistor. There are four resistors are connected. So we have to find out the value of unknown resistance value. So here, this bridge consists of the four resistors. It can be connected as shown in this figure. So P, Q or S. And also the terminals that we connected, that A, B, C and D. And galvanometer that is connected between the terminal B and D. So this is the circuit connection, and also the terminal A and C are connected to the potential difference. So here, so in this potential difference, the current can be comes from positive terminal and it goes to the bridge, and in the A terminal it can be split into the two current value I1 and I2 from this direction, and the current goes to the B terminal, it can be split into two current value, that is galvanometer current IG, then I3. So then here the D terminal also goes through the this direction of current, that is I4, and it can be comes and meet in the terminal C, then goes downward direction and it goes to the negative terminal. So this is consist of the Wheatstone bridge. For applying first rule in the terminal B and D, so first for applying the first terminal at B, so applying the Kirchhoff's current rule in junction B, so what happened? I already told you the first rule, remember that. So the sum of the algebraic sum of all the current values at any junction is equal to zero. So here the B terminal is there. There are how many current is there? 1, 2, 3. Three currents are there. So towards the junction we have to taken as a positive value, and away from the junction we have to taken as the negative value. Here only one value is towards the junction and two values are away from the junction. So what is the value? So I1 minus IG minus I3 is equal to 0. That is your first equation. Then goes to the junction D. So for applying the same rule. So here there are three current values are there at the junction D. So I2, IG, then I4. So which one is the plus value? Positive value. So here towards the junction I2, then plus IG, then minus I4. So that is equal to 0. That is equation number 2. So these are the two equation at junction B and junction D. Then goes to the third equation. So now you have to consider the Kirchhoff's voltage rule to the loop. We have to select the two loops for applying the Kirchhoff's second rule. So for the loop of A, B, D, A. So where is that? A, B, D, A. So this is one of the loop. For this loop, we have to apply the second rule here. So first we have to take, so A, B, D, A. First we have to take A to B, then B to D, then D to A. So applying, so you have to keep it in your mind, this value only, not this values all, right? So we have to take only that loop only. So for first loop, so what is the second rule? The algebraic sum of the product of I and R, that is current and resistance, that is equal to total EMF which is present in the circuit. So that is a second rule. So here there is no EMF in this loop, so that is equal to 0. So for current value, you have to see the direction of current value also here. So this only shows that it is comes from the positive terminal, isn't it? The positive value can be splitted into two then. So it goes this direction and comes this direction, and this finally go to finish this direction only, that is clockwise direction. But here it can be in the against, that is oppose that value. So we have to take this value only, the negative value. So second rule applying. I1, applying the second rule, I1P plus IgG minus I2R is equal to 0. There is no EMF for that circuit. So I1P plus IgG minus I2R is equal to 0. That is the third equation. Then take the another loop also. A, B, C, D, A. So where is that? A, B, C, D, A. You have to remember this value only. So not for that connection of G value. So you just forgot that value. You have to take the loop A, B, C, D, A only. So applying the second rule here, there is no EMF for the circuit also. So one of the term, that is right hand term 0, then you have to take the left hand term only. So I1P plus I3Q, so minus I4S and minus I2R. So this is the value for applying the second rule. So I1P plus I3Q minus I4S minus I2R is equal to 0. That is equation number 4. So next, Ig is equal to 0. So the current from galvanometer is equal to 0 because galvanometer always shows the null deflection because of balancing the length. So that's why Ig is equal to 0. Always shows the null deflection only. We have to take the value. That is only balancing the circuit. So that's why we take Ig is equal to 0. So first equation, what is the first equation? I1 minus Ig minus I3 is equal to 0. So this term is 0. Then I1 minus I3 is equal to 0. So first equation will be I1 minus I3 is equal to 0. So I1 is equal to I3. That is equation number 5. So apply this value in also second equation. So I2 minus I4 is equal to 0. I2 is equal to I4. That is equation number 6. Then apply in the third equation also. So third equation, this term will be 0. Then I1P minus I2R is equal to 0. So I1P minus I2R is equal to 0. Then I1P is equal to I2R. So three equations, that Ig part will be 0. Then the equation can be rearranged like this. So then applying all the values in equation number 4. Equation number 4, the last loop. You are applying the second rule in the last loop. So equation number 4, here I1P, so I1P is there. So instead of I3, we substitute I1 value. Instead of I4, apply the I2 value. So I1P plus I1Q minus I2S minus I2R is equal to 0. Then take the common values. So I1 for these two terms, then I1P plus Q minus I2S plus R. That's why take the sign, that is minus sign also, take it in the common value, is equal to 0. Then I1P plus Q is equal to I2S plus R. So this is equation number 8. So divide the equations. That is, divide equation number 8 by equation 7. So equation 8, I1P plus Q, then I1P plus Q in this side, and what is the value of equation 7? I1P. So that is divided by that value. So denominator I1P is equal to I2S plus R divided by I2R. So I1 cancel, I2 cancel. The final equation is P plus Q divided by P is equal to S plus R divided by R. So this is the value. Then we have to split that two value into P by P plus Q by P. So this is a common value numerator. We have to separate the two terms, then this value. Then R by R plus S by R. So this term will be 1 plus Q by P is equal to 1 plus S by R. Then Q by P is equal to, we have to cancel that one value here also. Suppose if you are confused, means take that value in this direction. So in this term, minus 1 and plus 1 can be cancelled. Then Q by P is equal to S by R. So or it can be rewritten as P by Q is equal to R by S also. Suppose, so this is the last final equation. This is the bridge balance condition. This value, so what is the purpose of this value? Means suppose we have to find out the unknown resistor, means we have to find out that value. Finally, unknown resistance can be determined by this equation.